And welcome back to Sir, You Are Being Hunted with me, Will, and still not a single Dan in sight. I considered hiring a Dan that none of you have ever met, just so that I'd at least have a Dan by proxy, but sadly no. After that wonderful little four kill, I'm very proud of that, I've had a little meat cook-off, so we're now stocked for delicious cooked venison. And as we continue our search for just enough pieces of the magical MacGuffin, we might make it out of here alive. I do declare, we are finding delicious food types all over. So yes, before I was telling you stories of the extra credits crew and how wonderful they were, the thing is, Things are very different now. The extra credits team are larger than they were, which is a wonderful, wonderful thing. I mean, people like Soraya, who have... Oh, what is your deal? What is your deal? Are you just waiting for me to get close to the shoreline? God. I mean, Soraya is a joy and a godsend, as it is now possible to actually hang out with James for more than about 2 seconds, as she has succeeded in organising that man at events. In the past, trying to get a meeting with James at an event usually involved running with him from one panel to another, or desperately trying to track him down at some varying... Ooh! Interesting. Flask of lukewarm tea! Frederick, I'll have no judgment from you now. James is... Okay, James as in James Portnow. The wonderful writing mind behind, well, I guess, extra credits in its antithesis, is a wonderful fellow. And again, if you ever get the chance to meet him at PAX or an event, totally do that. And once again, don't tell him I said anything nice. I will lie and said that he smelled like old cabbage. Sorry, I'm just getting a quick lay of the land. It's got the dramatic music on, which makes me slightly nervous. Oh, and I didn't even. So yes. Stalking through the varying foothills of this shenanigans. Yes. So if you get the chance to meet James at an event, totally do. However, he moves like a flash of lightning. To find him stood in more than one place for a minute usually means that someone else has managed to talk to him, ensnare him in conversation like a bear trap. Because he just doesn't stop moving. I've seen him run from panel to panel to panel in triple combo fashion. I've seen him lead a tour of people on a... Ooh, is that a plume of smoke? No. Bugger. I've seen him lure? Jeez, I make it sound sinister. I've seen him lead a tour of people through an indie island expedition, which is possibly one of my favourite things. Getting James's kind of first time reactions on... a lot of the indie mega booth stuff at PAX and places like that is wonderful. So you absolutely, totally should do that if the opportunity ever arises. Sorry, I don't know what this is, but I'm going to check it out. No, boots and rats. Boots and rats. Oh, I could use slightly quieter boots. Oh, shit, the bed, that's a lot of them. Okay, we're not going near there. I'll have no bed pooping on my watch. I forget where this rambunctious, rambolic story was going, other than to highlight the fact that James moves like a bat out of hell when it comes to any events, and if you see him standing there, you should go and talk to him. I've had at least many a splendid Skype call with the gentleman over the subject of history, and... Oh, shit! Alright, remember me as I was. Beautiful and chatty. Alright, I can get one of them. Okay. It's got to come at me from the front. Come on. Ow! I say, that'd rather hurt. Oh, well. Rather unsporting. Come on. Ow! Oh, God. Okay, we're good. Oh, God, there's more of them. Christ. Christ. Just going to give it a little second here, ladies and gentlemen. I'm so sorry this is... There's one of those bastard striders over there. But so you're being hunted, you regain health so long as your vitality allows for it. The higher your vitality, I believe, the at least the quicker you regain health. Oh God, and there's the MacGuffin! More shotgun shells, so let's try and do this nice and close. I mean, we've got an axe if needs be, but one doesn't want to contend with the reactive reflexes of a robot hunting machine. Okay, it's dark. We've got 7 shotgun rounds, 12 rifle rounds, 10 pistol bullets, some gammon. It's dark and we're wearing sunglasses. I reckon we can do this. Nice and quiet. Nice and quiet. No one need ever know. Oh, he beeped. Don't beep. This isn't a beep situation. Sneaking, sneaking, sneaking. Singing my sneaking song. Sneaking, sneaking, sneaking. Please don't look at me with your horrible red robot eyes. I'm genuinely terrified. I'm gonna run into that castle in the night. I sing when I'm nervous, okay? Okay, okay, right. I just wanted to tell you guys a story about James and how we talked about history a couple times and it was good and okay. Now I don't know where I am. I'm lost, it's dark. I think this is a different statue to a different person. Yes, it is. This is a statue for Martin Davies, a poet engineer. What a great title. But we got a MacGuffin. There's a lot of individuals in the dark there. Lordy, lordy. I'm not enjoying this brush. I do believe in the sanctity of our planet and the protection of animals and whatnot. Oh, terribly, excuse me. I think it's all that coffee and tea I've been slugging all day. But, lordy, lordy. I could quite happily go for some deforestation right about now, just so I get a clear line of sight. If there are anything that you'd like me to chat about, tell stories on, or if you have any questions about games industry, whatnot, or being a community manager, please throw them in the comments below. Or if you just want to mock me shamelessly for my fear of the very real robots that rule over our poor English countryside, then throw those in the comments as well. I'm going to continue my little sprint away from fear. It's getting lighter. Actually, you know how I mentioned I wanted it to be deforested and open? I take that back. I actually preferred it a lot more when I had things to hide behind. Oh, I just just need the MacGuffin detector. That would make my life so much easier. Okay. Oh, hello, you. I'm so glad Tentacle Arms is here. I was worried you wouldn't be around. I need a name for him. I'll have Frederick head on it. Frederick, the butler! Oh. Come play, sir, you are being hunted, they said. It'll be fun, they said. Christ. I'm genuinely sweating, and you can't even see it. I'm leaving sweat patches on my desk, and not in a fun way. Ah, right. So yes, James Portnow, a man of history. See, I worked on the Total War series, which I thoroughly, thoroughly love doing. And one of the things that I guess was interesting for me is that I love the Total War series as a gamer. I didn't have the kind of classical history knowledge that a lot of my colleagues at the time did. I just really bloody loved the games. I thought the real-time fights were good, and I really liked the kind of the turn-based like Empire Conquest. And I kind of liked the fact that those two were separate. How are we doing for stuff? We're doing fine. We don't really need to go into that town. Let's continue on the outskirts for now. All the resources we consume now are potentially resources that we might need later. Yes. So, for me, one of the great things about working on the Total War series was I learned a lot about the history of the games that I'd enjoyed. Oh, is this where we came in? Oh, yes, because there's only one. That means there's a load more MacGuffins. We're going to have to go inland. I prefer not to. There's a lot of them as well. Lordy, lordy. Okay, we'll try and skirt around the town. So, one of the fascinating things... sorry. Distracted by those glowing red lights in the distance. So yes, working on games like Rome 2 and Shogun 2, I learned so much in-depth knowledge, in-depth history stuff about those time periods. It was fascinating. So learning how we switched over from, you know, the glory days of Rome to the medieval, the kind of the Dark Ages, if you will, was really interesting. In England, you get taught the kind of the basics of the Roman Empire because of its impact in kind of, you know, later English society. But you don't really get taught how we went from being, you know, half owned by one of the greatest empires in the world to being into this kind of like this historical blackout period that blotted out quite a lot of information. So learning about that was really fascinating. Sorry, I'm just seeing if I can see any threats or problems. So one of the great things was when I first started talking to James on the concept of extra credits doing some work for the Total War guys, making some video content around, well, history, if you will. I only see two, but I know there's more. No, it's too risky. We'll go into the brush. It was wonderful to learn that James just had this freaking encyclopedic knowledge of so many incredible eras in history, and I learned a ton just from chatting with him on Skype. I mean, especially about the fall of Rome and how its economical downfall was such a huge part in well, everything else. Just gonna have a quick bit of cooked meat in case we need to peg it or in case we end up bleeding. Oh, piss. They are coming this way. Are those hunting dogs? Alright, this might turn into, sir, you're running like a panicked mess towards somewhere you need to go. I don't know how many MacGuffin pieces I need. Oh, God, my heart. So yeah, that was one of the fascinating things is... Okay, I'm good, I'm good. The stuff that would later on to become some of the great series from Extra History. Oh, God!
I'll be quiet now, sir. Just let you get on with things. Good luck.
What just happened? Did he just gun down one of his own? Certainly look like it. Yeah, so all the stuff about Constantinople and all the incredible history around what would be referred to as the Byzantine Empire was brilliant, and I'd never heard of that. Like, the split between the Roman Empire is just something that's not discussed in kind of like basic English history teaching. So, ugh. So, oh. Shit, they heard me. So it was absolutely wonderful to hang out with James. More tea, Vicar. To hang out with James and learn about these fantastic things. All right, okay, I will continue this tale momentarily. Oh, you villainous robotic ball bag. I know you're round here. Bloody terrifying me. Yeah, we agreed, no drinking. For the rest of this run, we will attempt to be teetotal. And by we, I mean me. Ah, the pink sun, one of my favourites. Oh my god, where are you? My little heart can't take this. Got it, don't need it. Pickled onions, yay! Pickled onions a common thing in the US? I've never really asked anyone. Pistol bullets, yay! They can be found in almost every chip shop up and down the UK. Oh, I bloody hear you, where are you? There they are, okay. I think we've got as much of out of this area as we're going to, so let's head to that church over there. Sorry about this. Don't look at me, I'm over here. Oh bugger, I know where we are. We've done a full bloody loop, and not in a good way. There's two bots around here. Okay, I don't think I'm going to be able to get anything, to make any headway very quickly. There's dogs over there, there's robots over there. Oh, thank you for watching another episode of Sir, You Are Being Hunted, without any Dans, which I'm still sad about. I will be continuing my desperate attempts to survive in the English countryside in the next episode. So please stay tuned, and Christ, how am I going to handle this? Bye!